everyone, Mugman Reviews, and today we'll be taking a look at the Marvel Legends Vintage Wave Captain America by Hasbro. First, let's take a look at the packaging, paying homage to the old Toy Biz figures, I think it was. We got a bio in multiple languages, which there's a glare on my camera. Sorry to whoever actually reads that, but I'll read the American and just look at the subtitles. Captain America is the ultimate super soldier, and he's ready to battle for justice. Good hero. We got the other figures in the wave, the Black Widow, which I swapped the head for that Mary Jane custom. Iron Man, which I want to get for my brother. Punisher, which I want to get for myself. And that Spider-Man, which I also want to get for myself. Maybe give that Wolverine to my brother. If I can ever find them. Don't really get up as much as I'd like to. In fact, I only really got this guy because me and my sister were at GameStop, and we go to GameStop more often than we'd like to admit, but hey, I was there, and I saw this guy, and I was like, you know what? I think I'll do it. Also, lovely people at the GameStop near my house, very lovely people.
Let's get to it and crack this thing open, and I'm actually going to turn it off this time because, dear God, that was so cringy last time. Or yet, why don't we just use the magic of transitioning? 3, 2, 1.
Hey, what do you know? It really worked! Now we have the figure out of the packaging, and since I did that snap, I have no idea where his alternate hand went.
Okay, hold on. Here it is. So, why don't we take a look at this figure's details, and then we'll take a look at all that articulation and whatnot, whatever else we do. I'm still new to this whole figure thing. I think he's trying to salute. Okay, well, you guys are unfamiliar with Captain America somehow. This is his original costume, from like the 40s. The mesh chainlink or whatever this is just painted on. Or if you don't recognize it from the 40s, it's the suit he should currently be wearing in Mark Waid's Captain America. There's a peg hole for putting the shield. Yeah, there's a peg on it. It goes into this part here. But it's got a nice light blue, like in the 40s. Unfortunately, it didn't come with his other shield, his original shield. That would have been kind of cool to change the shields. But hey, I ain't complaining. It's like my first Captain America figure here. I've always wanted to get one, but never really knew which one to get. And I decided, you know what? I'm at GameStop. There's a Captain America. It's the vintage way, might as well. On the other hand, I literally just got this figure and just got him out of the packaging, so as I'm reviewing it, I'm seeing more and more to this figure. Let's say this though, the ball joints in his shoulders are kind of stiff. Maybe that's just with mine, but let's get into that articulation. His head can look up about this much, and down about that much. Looks pretty good bit down. I guess a fair amount up. I mean, I've seen Toy Biz figures that can look higher. But that's neither here nor there. It's got an ab crunch that only goes about that far. Well, gee, that's disappointing. But Captain America is kind of agile, but, you know, it's not like he's going around doing flips and crap like he's Spider-Man. Okay, and he can only go about that far back. Good to know. At the shoulders, we got ball joints that can go out about... Oh, let me set that down. About that much. And I don't want to force it beyond that, because I got a bad feeling about that. Swivel at the biceps. Double-jointed elbows. Hinged wrist that also rotates because it's a peg hole. Got a waist swivel, which would probably go 360, but I don't know, that's just too weird. Hips go out about that much, so he can go kick somebody in the knee. And they go back about that far, not very far, but then again, how far back do your legs go? They go forward about that far. Double-jointed knees, as you can see. Swivel at the shin, which I haven't been seeing a lot in like Spider-Man figures made by Hasbro. And last time I really saw that, I think, was on the Peter Parker Ultimate Spider-Man. I have yet to get the Miles Morales one, but what the hell, Hasbro? Come on. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. We've got, ankle pivot. You know, Hasbro's Epic and Craze Ankle Pivot, and Ankle Rocker. So that's it for Cap's articulation. This being a Captain America figure, he stands a bit above 6 inches. Huh. Is it just me or is that kind of short? I mean, I think I actually have taller Spider-Men. In fact, why don't I go do a size comparison with the magic of snapping finger transitions? Here he is next to Black Widow, who has the head of one of the movie Black Widows, because Mary Jane custom. Which I say looks pretty nice. Can't really move her head at all. Tried that and it broke the peg, I hot glued it, and I don't want to try anything. He's also standing next to Captain Universe, which he stands like almost. I think Cap's a bit taller. Even a bit taller than Black Widow. Now let's take Black Widow away and put in two more figures. With the power of snap transitions. Actually, I re-measured this guy. I guess maybe it was where I was measuring or how I was doing it. Seems this Captain America is about 6.5 inches tall. Here he is next to the Pizza Spider-Man, who's just a bit shorter than that. The Ultimate Spider-Man, which the scaling works, but this is not an Ultimate Captain America. Remember that time, like, Cap was trying to train Spidey in the Ultimate Universe? And here he is next to Mary Jane, which I have no idea if I should make this a 616 Mary Jane or an Ultimate. I know she's kind of taller than him, but that wouldn't be accurate, so maybe she should just go with Peter. Grown-up Peter. But that's my review, guys. Hope you dig it. Maybe, if you're really lucky, I'll have a gallery of images of this guy on Google+. And if you're thinking, but Mugman, Google+ is a dead social media. It was never alive. I only ever got one because YouTube made it a requirement. Well, I'll catch you guys later. And have a good day, everyone.